Hello everyone and welcome to the Highline Community Symphonic Band's March Concert. We're so grateful for your presence and we hope that you enjoy tonight's program. My name is Corey Smith and it's been my honor to serve as the interim director of the band for this past term. Our concert is titled Old, New, Borrowed, and Blue, and each piece presented this evening is going to include at least two of those adjectives. Some of them maybe even more. So I hope you're able to snag a program. You can scan the QR code so you can check out more detailed program notes. You can click on links to learn about the composers, and you can check out all of the lyrics that are associated with these songs, and feel free to sing along. Our first piece, however, doesn't have any words. This was originally written for an organ by one of the most famous organists of all time, Johann Sebastian Bach. His old work, Prelude and Fugue in D minor, is commonly used to depict things that are sad or blue. See what I did there? It's a really, really fun introduction to the ensemble. When we get to the fugue, it's a four-voice fugue, and it's going to pass the subject through every single section of the band. So I thought that'd be a good way to introduce you to this wonderful group. Please enjoy Moehlmann's arrangement of Bach's Prelude and Fugue in D minor.
Thank you.
Our second piece, Where the Waters Meet, was borrowed from an old British tune called Oh Wally Wally, and there's several literal references to water, which throughout tonight will be interpreted as blue in many different senses. This new setting by Carol Britton Chambers features our wonderful low brass section, and it kicks off with a couple trombone solos. This is our rendition of The Water is Wide. Ticheli borrowed and made new for the wind band medium. The first movement is a nature song, and you're going to hear a three-note bird call motive that's passed through especially the upper woodwinds and the upper brass. The second movement is a dance song, and the Shakers were somewhat notorious for having rowdy religious services, which is a surprise to me based on some of their other traditions, but the dancing was a very big part of it, so you get to hear a little bit of a Shaker dance. The third song is a lullaby, and the Shaker community very much value children, whether they were their own. They also are quite famous for taking in other people's children if they needed some additional care. So they had quite a large community of foster children and orphans that were welcomed into the Shaker community. And then the fourth movement is perhaps the most famous, especially thanks to Aaron Copeland, who featured the theme in Appalachian Spring. And that's where the entire suite gets its name. It's Good Old Simple Gifts. So again, all the lyrics are available in your program if you would like to check them out. And there's more information about the Shakers. There's still one community left in America. Their value of celibacy hasn't paid off in terms of growing said community, but it's still, she got the joke. But there is still one community, and they're still practicing most of the original Shaker tenets. So please enjoy our four movement suite of simple gifts.
Thank you.
very, very well. Thank you. We are heavily borrowing music tonight. Like, the wind band medium is not that old, really. It's really not that old. So a lot of the most traditional music in our medium was actually borrowed from folk songs. But I wanted to, like, pay honor to the roots of wind band. And so we're going to close this half with a march by the most famous march composer in America, John Philip Sousa. This march is called Who's Who in Navy Blue, and hopefully that's self-explanatory why it's programmed. A lot of people associate Sousa with the Marine Band since he enlisted when he was 13 and was one of the leaders of the Marine Band for about 19 years. But later on, in 1917, he was actually requested to be a lieutenant in the Navy, right when we were getting into World War I. And he led the Naval Band for a whopping fee of $1 a month. He donated everything else he made to a relief fund for both the Marines and Naval officers who were injured during the war. So that's kind of nice. If you or anyone in your family has served, this is a nice opportunity to say thank you to you as well. But please enjoy John Philip Sousa, Who's Who in Navy Blue. Of folk music in America. They, of course, have deeply religious meanings, but a lot of Black spirituals also had hidden messages within the text. And in this famous spiritual, Wade in the Water, the text has to deal with helping slaves escape to freedom. And if they were to use streams and rivers as a part of their travel, they could help erase their scent for the bloodhounds that were tracking them. And so there's also some lyrical references to Harriet Tubman and Moses. This is a very different take on a spiritual. It's much more stormy. And it has to do, the composer writes in this program notes that it has to do with the line, God's gonna trouble the waters. And so you're gonna hear that trouble in Adolphus Hailstork's New Wade and Water. In a single movement, kind of like a symphonic poem, so there's not going to be breaks between them, but you'll hear some very obvious style changes. It's been quite the adventure working on it. You're going to hear probably more notes in this piece than the previous six so far. And you're going to hear maybe 80,000 times more time changes for those musicians in the audience than you've heard so far, too. So I'm super proud of them for their work. Feel free to peruse the program notes to learn more about the origin of each piece, but I hope you fall in love with Alfred Reed's Armenian Dances, Part 1.
Thank you.
to talk a little bit about this next piece, but super proud of them for pulling that off. The next piece might be my favorite on the program. Grace Before Sleep was a poem of gratitude originally penned by Sarah Teasdale, and she's the first winner of the Pulitzer Prize. When she won it, we didn't call it the Pulitzer Prize, it was called the Columbia Poetry Prize back in 1918. And she wrote this poem on Thanksgiving, which is very fitting. Susan LaBarr, who's a very big name in the choral education community, used Teasdale's words and wrote an absolutely gorgeous melodic arrangement in 2011, so like over 100 years later. J. Eric Wilson, who's the director of bands at Baylor, heard the choral arrangement and was like, oh, we gotta get in on this. And so he wrote a band arrangement in 2013, and since then it's just exploded. There's now arrangements for band and choir, there's orchestral arrangements, it's been performed all over the world, and I absolutely love it. I think it's beautiful text on its own, and I think it's beautiful music on its own, and when it's together, it's fantastic. So I know it's in your electronic program, but I think it's worth reading too. How can our minds and bodies be grateful enough that we have spent here in this generous room this evening of content? Each one of us has walked through storm and fled wolves along the road, but here the hearth is wide and warm. And for this shelter and this light, accept, O Lord, our thanks tonight. So I want to express my own gratitude to the ensemble behind me, who's welcomed me with open arms this cycle and has made each Monday night such a joyous experience. Not many people can say they like Mondays, but I like Mondays with this group. So I would encourage you to listen to this new arrangement from an old and borrowed poem, to think of people in your life, things in your life for which you are grateful. And if you're like me and are grateful for the band, there is a horn aplenty over there that could be more plentifully stuffed by the end of this evening, if you get my drift. But as you're feeling grateful, we would love any assistance you can provide, just helping with the rental spaces and the music costs of keeping this ensemble going. Please enjoy Grace Before Sleep. I'm just going to keep the thank yous going. Thank you to Highline High School for the use of their theater equipment, lights, and sound. To our Highline Community Symphonic Band Board for all the grant writing and the organization and the countless hours behind the scenes to keep this band afloat. I already thanked the ensemble, but they deserve it twice. Thank you, band. And maybe most importantly, thank you to all of you, the audience. We work really hard all by ourselves for weeks and weeks and weeks to put this together, and you complete the performance cycle. It's our job as artists to take what the composer has written and bring it to life, but it doesn't really have much meaning if the message just stays with us. We need our message to go to you and hopefully have an impact on you. So thank you so much. Time is one of those things that is a really precious commodity, and so it means a lot that you're spending time with us tonight. So thank you so much for coming out. Our final piece is a medley of songs borrowed from good old Broadway from the 1985 musical Les Mis, which is coming to the Fifth later this spring. I'm not getting paid for that, but I still support them. You should go check out Les Mis. If you are not familiar with Les Miserables, it was a 19th century novel by Victor Hugo, and loosely translated means the miserable one. So now we're back to sad and blue. Borrowed old and new, all four. Boom. So sit back and relax. This is a hefty medley. Like, you're going to love it. There's lyrics if you feel like singing along, if you have some show tune backgrounds. But we'll start with At the End of the Day. I dreamed a dream, master of the house, on my own, and do you hear the people sing? Thank you again for coming out tonight, and we hope you enjoy highlights from Les Mis.
Thank you.
But if you wanna sing, do you hear the people sing as you leave? That's okay. Thank you again so much for coming, and we hope to see you in June for the next cycle under the direction of Mr. Jordan. Woohoo! In the audience.